we should give the opportunity to the incoming president of the SRC here to come and speak to you. And you must listen to him, you must judge him by what he says.
All members and disciplined soldiers of the EFF, together with the members of the opposition who came to join us, who are certain that they are going to vote for the EFF because they do not have confidence in SASCO. That is why you see them on my far left coming to listen to the EFF, because none of our fighters went to listen to an educated minister who came to make noise at the student center. We are standing up today as the leadership of the EFF Student Command to tell all of you and all members of the EFF, all supporters, all fans, and members of the EFF, and also the students of the Northwest University, that the 12 of us who are going to office, they are not going to office because they are individuals, but you are going to office because you are members of the EFF, and we are instructed to perform the mandate of the EFF. Our responsibility as the leadership is to ensure that there is no student who is financially excluded, a student who is denied to access the university because he or she is having outstanding balances. You must know that the leadership of the EFF, who will never leave students when they are break-ins in residences to fly and go to America for lunch time. You must know, when we come back from recess in July, we have seen them, the members of the SRC, representing the South African Student Congress, when students were told to vacate the residences because they did not pay the residence fees. They did only thing, they have booked a flight ticket to go to Korea. They came back. When we have responded to all the challenges of students, when we are out of office as the EFF-led student command. You must know, all of you, and I want to tell you on record, that you must know that Professor Kwadi is a white man. And you must know, all of you, that Professor Kwadi never loved us. You must know, all of you, that those who have been appointed at the IEC, they are friends of Professor Ken Kwadi. You must know, all of you, you must know that Mukwati, who disqualified our candidate for legal affairs, has been a spy of Professor Kwadi in 2008. It does not come as something new today that you are told that our candidate has been quite qualified. But I'm standing to tell you tonight here that will never happen in our watch. You must go and tell them. Those who are sitting in the tribunal now, who advocate Mungate and others, they must know that once they put this mic down, we are coming to demand to them that they must reinstate our candidate. You must all know that the EFF Student Command never appointed its candidates for the SRC. They were elected in the Branch General Assembly on the 20th of this month, when all other organizations, they have went to appoint their leadership. That is why they do not respect the decisions that you have made. And many of them, after you have elected your substructures, they will go and disband them because they are not in favor of them. That is not the EFF Student Command. I want to tell and reassure all of you that before you can be admitted into residence for the academic year 2016, none of the 12 SRC members will accept admission into residences when our students are locked out of the system. You must know that the leadership of the EFF that is coming into office on the 2nd of September, we will never accept the leadership bazaar if you are not taking it to assist those who have been financially excluded. You must know, all of you, that the EFF Student Command will never abandon you. Those who are sitting down and saying those students who have lost their laptops due to robbery, they must now get the desktops. When we meet in our first managerial meeting, the first attempt on the agenda will be, when are you giving our students back their laptops? That is the first issue on the agenda. You must also know that the EFF-led SRC will never accept the library that is operational from 8:30 until 10 p.m. The first thing that you will do, the second item on the agenda, is when are you opening the library for 24 hours? Oh, yeah. We don't want meme when we get into office. We want the date and time. When is that going to happen? Because when we came out of the library, when we come out of the meeting, and we are not told when is the date and when is the time, when we get out of that meeting on that evening by 9:30, we mobilize all students to enter the library, and we are going to study for 24 hours. The leadership of the EFF. And you must know, all of you, that because you are responsible to adhere to the seventh cardinal pillar of the EFF for corrupt free government, for transparency, we will make sure that the policy of residence is reviewed by the masses of our people. It will not be reviewed by the SRC locking themselves into the offices, because it is the leadership of SASCO that have ensured that many of you who qualifies do not get residencies, and their friends who are in extra year, who are studying in the university, they have got the opportunity to stay there. You must all know that none of you under the watch of the EFF will be disqualified, will be removed from examination, will be denied access to institutions of higher learning, and will be denied NSFAS. You must know that education, it is not a privilege, but it is a right. And all of us, we must have it. We do not align ourselves with the principles of the Freedom Charter, because we are like President Zuma. We don't know what they mean. You must know, when we say the doors of learning and culture must be opened for all, what do we mean? You will see it happening from this campus under the leadership of the EFF Student Command. And many of them who said we are calling our leadership because they are celebrities and they would not be here in January when you are running a crisis of financial exclusion. You must know that yes, Commissioner Floyd will not be here, but firstly, before they expel one of you, they will have to meet me first as the president. I am saying this to you because they know very well, those whom their qualifications are questionable in the offices, that the first thing that they have done was to ensure that myself and the Deputy President of the Student Command leaves office as soon as January before we can sit for registration fees. Because they knew very well that without other students registering, there can never be registration processes. By the way, little did they know that there will be the return that is coming in on the 2nd of September to continue with our business that you have left behind. And many of you, you must continue to know that the EFF leadership and led SRC will never leave you like those who have left you and they went to Korea. You must know that the money, when they come to us, Professor Kwadi, to say take the money and buy the ticket to Korea, we will say bring that money here. because you want to take these students who are having outstanding balances to pay for them. You must know that the 10 million that has been donated and stolen by James Ilof, when we get down into office, we will say, if you want to increase fees, take from the 10 million that you have to give. That will never happen. That will never happen in our world. By the way, those who don't know, that the university is spending more of money into bashes. They will give the SRC 500,000 to say organize the freshers ball. We will say to them, we need that 500,000. Bring it into the coffers of the SRC, because we must pay for students who are having issues of outstanding balances, who are having outstanding tuition fees, who wants to register and graduate in May. We want nothing else but that money, because it will assist you to ensure that you deal with poverty decisively where we come from. You must know that poverty can never define us. Poverty can never be our future. Poverty can never determine our direction. You must know, all of you, that poverty can only make us strong and encourage us till we have attained free education and economic freedom in our lifetime. I'm told that I'm speaking too much. I will just leave the mic. And I'm not going to do that. Let me continue with two more issues. You must know that every student who will be brought before the disciplinary committee will be represented by the SRC led by the EFF. By the way, those who do not know, the EFF Student Command and the secretary of this branch is also representing a member of SASCO in the DC. Because when they came to us, we never said to them, we can't represent you because you are a member of the ANC. But we said, because you are a student and we are an organization of students, this does not exclude you. We will represent you in the DC until you win your case. I want to speak now to the female students who have been doing private consultation with lecturers in their offices, and they've been harassed by lecturers. When they want to go out, they're intimidated and told that should you report, you will never pass. When we step into office, there will never be sexual harassment. Because the first thing that a lecturer must do, he must lecture, he must teach and get out of the class and ensure that you pass as a student. When you do not pass, they must account why our students are not passing when they have paid a lot of money for their modules. All of you, you must know that the EFF-led SRC will never abandon you.
As a South African Student Congress, simply because, comrades, we are an organization which on its own derives its existence from student grievances. Simply because we are of an understanding that without our very own student, there is no SASCO. We remain an organization which is charged with the responsibility of organizing students in this particular institution that we find ourselves in. We were there, comrades, when our students were facing serious issues of academic exclusion. We were there as the sons and daughters of the working class, for we understood that as an organization, we have to play a major role and ensure that our students do not suffer in our expense, comrades. Hence, we are here as an organization. We said, comrades, as an organization, and said part of the things that we must implement in our manifesto at the South African Student Congress, it is to introduce a regular inter-faculty debate. So, comrades, we believe that we remain an organization which believes that the contestation of ideas, it is necessary in any academic institution rather than an artificial unity of purpose. Hence, we are here as the South African Student Congress, comrades. We understood, comrades, that as the sons and daughters of the working class, as the South African Student Congress, the main reason why we are saying no to fee increment It is on the basis that, comrades, the status quo that we find ourselves in does not reflect the same, comrades. We are saying this because we are still sitting in overcrowded CLPs. Hence, we are still paying a maximum amount in this particular institution that we are in, comrades. We said, comrades, that the South African Student Congress, part of the things that we are saying no to, the increment, comrade. It is on the basis that we've got a reactionary Council of the Northwest University, which sits there in Poch's room and take decisions on behalf of the ISRC, on behalf of the CRC. And because, comrade, like I said yesterday, it is not because that we've got a toothless student leadership, but we've got a reactionary management of the institution. Hence, we are here as a South African Student Congress, comrades. We said, comrades, our main idea and our main objective is when we assume responsibility, it is to challenge the issue of accessing our institution, comrades. First, because we believe that the theme of fee increment, it is the one which is keeping our students from being able to can come and register in this particular campus that we are in, comrades. Hence, we say the Council of the Northwest University must be disbanded. And that can only be attained as a when we stick together as members of SASCO and as students in general, comrades. However, comrades, we understood that the South African Student Congress, in as far as playing a major role is concerned, that there must be an implementation of a trust fund that is going to be formulated by the CSRC, comrades. And part of the things, comrades, that we said as an organization, simply because we keep on emphasizing an issue that as an organization, we maintain the standard of academic excellence, comrades. We said, comrades, we are contesting with 12 candidates of SASCO. We entrusted with the responsibility last year in August. And as such, comrades, we never betrayed our mandate under the leadership of Comrade Tutu Kobani, under the leadership of Comrade Hopola Molale, under the leadership of Maxwell Chazi. We remain resolute. We finished our time as deployees of SASCO. And we are saying, comrades, for there is a myth that there's a South African Student Congress, we are avoiding a debate, comrades. That can never be correct. We can stand boldly as members of SASCO, for we believe in the contestation of ideas. We are the first one to can articulate, comrades, a better stance in as far as the debate is concerned. We said we wanted a debate, comrades, but the opposition was too busy focusing on fraudulent identification, comrades. Hence why one of their members is disqualified as we speak, comrades. We were there, SASCO. We said, comrades, we are in an academic institution. And as far as addressing issues, let's go in a public debate, comrades. They never wanted such. They were busy forging documents, comrades. Hence, they are now disqualified. And we remain resolute with 12 candidates of SASCO, comrades. And one thing that we are going to forever emphasize, our age will never determine capacity. They think because they are old enough, now they are better to can lead. It's a myth, comrade, and I'm going to emphasize the point and I'm going to tell them. We have been seeking for this platform, now we are telling them, comrades. That will never happen in our expense. The leadership that we see here, it is more than capacitated to can ensure that we move towards our fundamental struggle, which is transformation agenda of the Northwest University Institution, comrades. However, comrades, we have noted that indeed there must be an implementation in as far as ensuring that our students who reside on campus, we increase the number of residences that we have on campus, comrades. And part of the things that we are calling for, comrades, it is a high level of maintenance in our residences, such as phase 3 residence, comrades, for we believe that they are not even renovated as in today, comrades. And however, comrades, we believe that there's a 12 candidates of SASCO, we will never disappoint in office, comrades. Because of now, we are entrusted with the responsibility last year, and we are still here, comrades. And we are said, comrades, when we are conducting our own manifesto, comrades, that will never be an organization which sits in its own office and want to create a manifesto on behalf of students. But our students must serve as an advisory board to the CSRC. They must hold the SRC accountable. They must forward their own submissions. They must make their own grievances to the SRC for them to can form part of our program of action in office, comrades. Hence, we are saying We are going to distribute our manifesto. And that manifesto, you must hold it with you, comrades, so that whenever we don't execute our mandate in office, you must be able to come to us as deployees of SASCO and name or point those which we are compromising in our own manifesto, comrades. We never sat in our office and conclude manifesto on behalf of students. Our very own students, we want to ask you, comrades, for we believe that you are going to make the right choice come the 31st and the 1st of September. We are saying the leadership which is here has enough capacity to can ensure that it advances our own interests, comrades. And one thing that we must guard against, it is the issue of individuals who may have changed color because of now they want to exploit and advance their own political interests on behalf of our student issues. Our issues of students are not theirs alone. Our struggle as SASCO, it is to see that our students' needs are attended to, and we will never sleep, comrades. And there are three things, comrades. For Comrade Chester, you'll find that as and when you check your own Facebook, a person will be writing, for example, it is radical, my boyfriend is coming for dinner. What's radical about that thing, comrades? We must never misuse or misquote words, comrades. And I'm going to tell them, for we are members of SASCO, and there is enough capacity and content. You'll find a person going to Mega City in his own or own status on Facebook. He or she is writing, we are going to nationalize Pick and Pay. And you find that that person is going to buy groceries. You can't nationalize Pick and Pay, comrades. You are busy lying to our students, for you suffering from societal recognition. And we are going to tell you, we are here at SASCO, we have never lied before, and we'll never lie to you. There is enough capacity, there is enough content. Hence we said, let's go for a debate. They refuse, comrades. Now we know them, we have exposed them, and we believe in SASCO. And this candidate has said, when they assume responsibility, they must just assist us, comrades. They must never be pompous. They must allow you to can direct them as the Northwest University students, comrades. And on that note, comrades, I want to thank you for your level of patience that you have exercised, for the trust and the belief that you have shown to us as an organization. We believe, comrades, that as when we are united, we can advance our own interests, for it does not rely only on this particular leadership. It relies on behalf of the students, it relies on students, and it relies on SASCO leadership. Hence, we are saying to you, comrades, let us make a right move and vote for SASCO the 31st and the 1st of September. For SASCO has never betrayed this mandate. They went into office 11 as they are. They moved as 11 as they are. Now we are going in that office as 12 as we are. And we are saying, comrades, as SASCO, we will never sleep with our own management. They remain reactionary because ours is to ensure that we advance student interests, comrades. That thing is a myth. SASCO will never betray our own student, comrades. We are not going to misuse words of radicalism. Our radicalism can only be seen as and when we are not, management is not meeting our requirements, comrades. Hence we are saying, yes, SASCO, we are disciplined. And one thing that they must know, it is that militancy on its own, minus discipline, it is equal to anarchy. And they must never mistake us, comrades. We are more than capable enough in terms of anarchy. But we believe that there's an organization, an engagement which is flexible enough, it is the one that can ensure that we move this particular institution forward. On that note, comrade, program director, I want to thank you again, comrades, and we are urging you, comrades, and making a humble plea, and also committing ourselves that we will never betray you. We are here to stay, and as a very get into office, will be a nuisance to the ears of management, will be a nuisance to those who are fearing transformation in this institution. We told them yesterday that we are coming for them, comrades. We don't fear them. We are here to stay. There is enough capacity. Thank you very much, comrade chairperson.